the judgment that was supposed to be given by the by CJ, which is a constitutional judge, Luke Malaba, was supposed to be consistent with the constitution of Zimbabwe. For him to hear our story, our application, he was supposed to have at least full bench to determine and to come up with a verdict. So that's what the constitution of Zimbabwe says. But he went on to hear the story on his own, and he made a verdict, which is unconstitutional, and it's a violation of the constitution. And we have got a strong feeling that his judgment is also void, null and unconstitutional. And also the proclamation by the president is also void and unconstitutional.
So are you going to challenge the proclamation?
We have already written this letter to the constitutional court. To the constitutional court, to the chief justice. We told him that his judgment was not done in line with the constitution. And therefore, we wanted this case to be heard by the full bench of judges, so that it won't be determined by an individual and should not be determined in the absence of other judges. So the proclamation done by the president, I'm sure it's unconstitutional, and we are not going to contest in those elections, because they are already they do not meet minimum requirements for free, fair, and credible elections, and they are not constitutional.
But there are other political partners who are willing to contest in those elections.
They don't know their constitutional rights. They don't know their constitutional rights, and they don't know the constitution. We had to take these guys to court because we cited a number of constitutional rights, especially chapter 4, in accordance with that. So there was no way we could just watch and see the violation of our constitution by the president himself and also by the Concord. Well, we didn't want this to appear as if it's a contempt of court, but we are speaking exactly what transpired, citing the constitution, and we've written him a letter that our order still remains, and we want our issue to be heard by the full bench.
So, are you saying that the judgment that you got is not correct?
In our view,
you are totally against the
yes. And this is Mr. Mo Precision, that is the president of the Voice of the People. We made the application together. You can as well.
What you are saying, actually, you are citing the constitution. What the constitution of Zimbabwe says, in section 166, 3A, it says, cases before the constitutional court concerning alleged infringements of a fundamental human right or freedom enshrined in chapter 4 must be heard by all the judges of the court. So what you are saying, the process which the Chief Justice went through is unconstitutional, it's ultra vires the constitution of Zimbabwe. It's a case of constitutionalism and legality and following the due process of law. What he did is unconstitutional. So the case has to be reset. As we've written to the Chief Justice, asking for a fresh reset of the case altogether.
Are you not trying to fight nature, since Zimbabwe is now in the election mood and everyone is ready to vote?
No, we're trying to entrench the culture of constitutionalism. This is what we're trying to inculcate. If you try to look at the supremacy, chapter 1, section 2 of the constitution talks of the supremacy of the constitution. So the president, whether it's the executive, the legislature, the judiciary, nobody's above the constitution. Natural and juristic pieces are all under the constitution of Zimbabwe. So therefore, we're trying to hold elections that constitutional. What kind of a nation are we going to have? A mafia state then. The due process of the law should be followed. We made an application to say the minimum benchmark for free and credible elections should not be met, citing the Political Parties Ordinance Act, which is saying it's ultra vires the constitution. Then, if that case is being decided illegally, what do we expect?
What do you consider as the minimum requirements of it?
Number one, amongst all other reforms, the Political Parties Finance Act must be repealed to allow funding for all other political parties.
But
we can't call it a contest where somebody's got 30 million to do politics from the treasury, taking taxpayers' money to do politics with it, and me, I've got nothing. And you call that a contest. Where's the contest? There is no contest. The election is already predetermined. The election results are already rigged in favor of the incumbent government, which used an act of parliament which is wrong in our eyes. It's illegal and it's wrong to have a head start over all other political parties. It's the incumbent government trying to deny other opposition parties oxygen to exist.
Country?
Not at all. If you look at the entire content of the Political Parties Finance Act, it denies us domestic funding. It then goes on even to illegalize foreign funding. But look at them, they're getting from the fiscus and they're getting from China. Me, if I want to get foreign funding, they say it's illegal. So where, how am I going to fund myself? They themselves, they're getting from the taxpayers.
Do you have evidence that they're getting?
That was part of our heads of arguments before the Chief Justice. I have, we can give you documentary evidence to show how ZANU-PF has been getting to the tune of millions support from China, from the government of China. This is not a secret, everybody knows that. Even the way they launched their liberation struggle, were they not getting outside help? So how are they promoting multi-party democracy? Well, chapter 4 of the Constitution of Zimbabwe says for the purpose of promoting multi-party democracy, an act of parliament should provide for the funding of political parties. So here the Constitution is envisioning an atmosphere where emerging parties get something, not where the incumbent government continues to hold the nation hostage through political finance, because the outcome of the election will be a reflection of political finance, not the true will of the people of Zimbabwe. They've held this nation for 38 years. Now we are a pariah state. What have they delivered? Nothing. And they want to continue to hold this nation through political parties finance act. That is not it.
Should they ignore
no, should they?
They ignore your call, your petition, what are you going to do?
Here, then we are saying, then Zimbabwe, just like Egypt, where there is no rule of law, where constitutionalism is a joke. Because if you try to look at chapter 1 of the Constitution of Zimbabwe that I'm holding here, it says the obligations imposed by this constitution are binding on every person, natural or juristic, including the state and all executive, legislative, and judicial institutions and agencies of government at every level, and must be fulfilled by them. So if they are saying, actually, ultra vires this constitution, then we have a mafia state. They are not legitimate. We have, everyone has to be
counted. How can you have a mafia state when you have the judiciary?
In Egypt, we call that a rational state.
Which saves all?
I'm giving you an example. In Egypt, do you have a rational state? The judicial decisions that are being made in the nation of Egypt makes, they are infamous the world over. The judiciary in Egypt is being used to persecute political opposition in Egypt right now. But it's called a judiciary, it's a mockery. So unless we have got a judiciary, an executive and a legislature that upholds this constitution, we are a mafia state. We have to live by the constitution. We should inculcate a culture of constitutionalism and the rule of law. Nobody, not even a member of the executive, the judiciary, or the legislature is above the constitution of Zimbabwe. This is the supreme law, as you can see. The supreme law. The supremacy cannot be undermined by anybody. Otherwise, you don't have any sense. The judiciary, the legislature, and the executive are a creation of the constitution of Zimbabwe. So if you do not respect that law that created the judiciary, the legislature, and the executive, what kind of a government do you have? Thank you.